Yes, this is Spanish. To be fair, the pastebin doesn't say anything about the language. Ironically, I kind of forgot to include that. Too lazy to put it in. Well, it was my first run with the fairy hover successfully. It took like an hour. But we did it, so I have a 234 now. The run that ended like 5 minutes ago ended because I failed to window jump and then went into the gossip stone trigger. I think 123, I think it can go lower, like if it's really good. Like with really good execution and first try fairy hover, like I'm pretty sure you could get a 120. But like realistically, I'm just gonna aim for like realistically with my execution right now, I'm just gonna aim for like a 125-ish, assuming I could get a first try fairy hover. Like, I got like a 129 Puppet Ganon last run, and that was really unoptimized. Ah. Nice slide. Slid across the A button. Oops. That was a bad orca. I mean, yeah, it's cool that we all got it. I'm not gonna, I mean, I'm doing the island hop from Great Fish to Western Ferry. Because it can be done relatively consistently. Yes, we're doing the fairy hover. Or we're gonna try it. I don't know if we're gonna actually succeed. But the goal is to hopefully succeed in less than an hour of attempts at the hover. Done runs of Ocarina of Time any percent, yes, but I did them like years ago. My PB is 21 minutes. I was able to tinker with your setup to find something that works for me, so it was good. I don't think I do exactly the same thing you do, but it's pretty similar, and I was able to get it to work for myself. Why am I running any percent? You know, I'm asking myself the same question also. Sucks. You don't learn a language by just playing a game in that language. Like, when you're speedrunning a game, you will never pay attention to the text, like, 99% of the time. There'll be a 100% category for Breath of the Wild, but it'll likely be longer than 24 hours. Yes. The she character, Katakana. You can take breaks if you want in a long speedrun, but that's gonna count towards your final time. Okay. Yes, this is gonna be like a 15-minute spoils bag. Yeah, I know you can pause, like once the fairy hits you. What's interesting, actually, is that, like, if you're in gamepad-only mode, you can actually pause, like, with the plus button during a zombie hover. At least I remember being able to do that, like, years ago, which I thought was strange. Well, gamepad only mode is just pressing the minus button. Yeah, that's the thing, Fuzzy. Makes it immensely easier to cheat. Even though, like, you can probably compare, like, the fairy positions and stuff. Hopefully RNGesus gives us his blessing. I mean, he did last run, but it was about after an hour or so of trying. Fail window jump this time. I think with pausing, you could theoretically mash at what the equivalent of 30 frames per second would be. But I'm not, like, 100% sure about that. Ha ha. Well, Fuzzy, to do light arrow skip, you need to get boomerang. Oh, you're talking about skip using the light arrows, then okay. But you're still gonna have to get light arrows to make Phantom Ganon appear. Because Phantom Ganon only appears once you actually go and get the light arrows. What does Grand Staircase skip have to do with light arrow skip? Yeah, you skip going to Quiver. That's why it's good. Are asleep. Oh no, someone took care of it. Thank you for the bits, though, but unfortunately you had to be banned. You're talking about skipping using the light arrows, Eagle, then yeah, you have to go get light arrows, then you respawn back in the hub room of Ganon's tower. And then you want the Phantom Ganon attack, where he surrounds you completely, and then do a parry off of one near a door. Boomerang strat is still TAS only, pretty much. It's also RNG, Fuzzy, because he might not spawn behind you every time. Yeah, but Fuzzy, you won't have any arrows. You're planning on skipping Quiver? Time for the mindless sail pumping. Using gamepad pausing? Maybe. You'd have to do, like, 180 frame-perfect pauses, though. So I don't know if that's exactly considered, like... I don't know. Because if you get 3 seconds... Or no, not 180, 90. I can't do math. I mean, I guess you could try that, Fuzzy, if you wanted to. And then, like, report back on it. Or just, like, test it after this run dies. Yes, I agree with Venix's statement. Yeah, I know, Fuzzy, I don't do the roll clip into Forest Haven. It was found, like, a while ago. Like, almost 3 years ago. Oh, hey, Loomis. I suppose you heard the news. The runs are unfortunately stupid, though. They require a fairy RNG hover. Wind Waker HD used to be faster because the Swift Sail was actually pretty fast, but now it's faster because Elemis Lighting exists, which has also led to the discovery of Barrier Skip. I'd do 100%, yeah. But not currently, though. Currently, we're doing any percent in all dungeons runs. Also, thank you very much, Majora's Base. With the Twitch Prime subscription, thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed the badge and the emotes, and thank you very much again for the support. Because this camera angle. That should be close enough. The run became faster because Barrier Skip became a thing, and with a well-executed run, Barrier Skip saves over 2 hours. Oh, thank you very much, Majora's Base. I'm glad you're enjoying the stream, and hope you continue to do so in the future. Though. Barrier Skip is just one single big Barrier Skip. Although I guess technically it's... You have to get past two separate barriers, but they're like right next to each other. There's a knockback barrier, and then there's a wall. Barrier Skip is actually pretty easy. You just have to do a really precise lineup. But like, if once you get the right angle, it's like a piece of cake. Thank you. I mean, you can zombie hover in here, but you can't use anything to heal yourself. Ugh. Nice. Up to your movement right here. Cycle. Oh, no, we're not. Slow somewhere. I barely missed it. Oh, well. It was my movement after blowing up the rock. It's always felt the same to speedrun. There wasn't a time where I didn't enjoy it. But in terms of, like, barrier skip, I guess, like, it makes it exciting, definitely, but the fairy hover is unfortunately stupid. Which is why I treat my 80% runs as just focusing on getting the fastest Puppet Ganon time possible. And if I get the fairy hover, that's just icing on the cake. So we don't have to blow up the warp pod this time, which I instinctually did last time. Shoutouts to the really loud planes up above. Last time. Not a very good DRC segment, though. Or, well, I guess the ending was okay. But could have been better. Yes, Tudas stating the hard facts here. Super swim. Other. Leaf early in HD is probably not going to happen, at least not with what we currently know. Because leaf early would require somehow skipping the grapple hook, which means that you'll need to gain height vertically somehow. And zombie hovering, you'd need to heal somehow.
Thank you.
no. And I'm not gonna go for Bulb Skip then. Beetle. Oh wait, no. Set up again. Guess we're going this way. That was unfortunately very slow. Lost like 50 seconds or something. This water level looks like it might be a soft lock also. Oh, no, not quite. Alright, the run continues. Not close enough. All right, this should be close enough. This side anyway. Okay. Position about there. Now I have to wait for the water level to go down. Alright. Cool trick. Can I get our quiver? Yes, once again, Tudas laying down the hard facts for us. That's false, though. You don't get any monetary prize for having a record. In case anyone was wondering, because some people seriously wonder that question. Yes, exactly. I was forced to pay Linkus7 $1,000 in hard-earned Twitch cash. When he bopped me last October, I think it was. You can't zombie hover if you have a fairy in a bottle, because the fairy just instantly heals you. You also, unfortunately, can't use cutscene items when you come up after being dead. Otherwise, you could just drink like a red potion or something. Close to falling off. Lost track of the timing. Alright, just go out. The savey warpy. I'm playing on release version. I don't think this game had any updates. Alright, now I'm swordless. No, I don't remember there being a day one update. As far as I remember. Everything's black now, which is pretty cool. Alright, so now we got the Gossip Stone, and that's all we're gonna do here. We're going to save warp back to Windfall, and do password skip again. I think we're gonna be losing time here. Also, yeah, this is all of the stuff we're doing right now is required for early Master Sword, which will be shown off in like 6 minutes. Mistake my last PB made. Yep. What the heck? Yep. Rip the sub one bombs. The only way you can get to Forsaken Fortress 1 is with no sword. That's why you have to go swordless. If you have a sword, then the lantern moblins don't catch you. Okay, time to complete this place. probably going the slow way because I like going slow. Nice. There's an item slide you can do here that I need to practice. It's really dark because the game is trying to apply the endless night lighting effect to this area. But that doesn't really work. Area wasn't programmed to handle this night. I did about an hour of attempts of the hover before I got it. Takes place on like the overworld and in Forbidden Woods or Forest Haven or like Dragon Roost, like the inner pond area. It's like the game's also trying to apply it to this map right now, and it's like it doesn't look too off, but the lighting is off right now. None of the objects have any shadows. Find the better angle for that clip so I don't have to swim back here every time. If you fail that super swim and like drown, then run's kind of over. random slides are bad. Nope. Okay. Hey, look, there's no door. Isn't that convenient? I just pull out the bombs, then drop them so that I get a third-person view of Link while he's sliding. Also, bomb count isn't, like, tight or anything. Like, you can waste, like, 20 bombs and still be fine. Yeah, they fixed the shield wheeling. Also, even in SD, I don't think the shield wheel happens unless you have the Master Sword, so... We have the Hero's Shield, or the Hero's Sword. So, the jiggle wouldn't happen anyway, even in the original. Pushed off. Still save time. Yeah, whatever. We saved time. I'll take it. Hey Chase, thank you for the good luck. I mean, I had a run finish, which is progress for this kind of category, so I'd say the runs are pretty good, considering the fact that I finished. So the Tower of the Gods doesn't exist, because we never raised it, so Valu's just kind of hovering in midair. Also, the last cutscene that we watched gave us the Master Sword. Splits are how far ahead I am total. Skip possible. I mean, it was just the fact that someone actually managed to get barrier skip with logged inputs. Dragon Man was able to figure out the exact requirements. This doesn't take long. Oh, dang. Still on. Hopefully this will work. Took like tries, I think, on my PB. Yeah, that's probably not gonna work. The lineup for this is really precise. I think I might be looking... I don't know. Yep. Because, like, the way that I figured out how to do this used color. There we go. Still 6 seconds faster. Oh boy. Funny. Really? Dang. I'm bad. All right. Enough with this madness. Actually, the madness hasn't even started yet. Failing that, like, should not happen. Still eons faster than my PB somehow. All right, we got the full package. Fire arrows, ice arrows, and light arrows. We have 60 arrows because of our upgrade. I should have... How much health do I have? I should have picked up the fairy. I have full health. I'm 1 minute ahead. Okay. I can see that. Minus 116 at light arrows. I know I can do it. What I want to know is if the fairies can do it. See how much of a joke I make this fight. Why is he coming towards me? I have enough light arrow or magic for two light arrow shots. I'm gonna need to get hearts from the keys anyway, so. Or no, okay, I should let him drop this time. Yeah, because the keys are pretty much going to drop hearts. Really? Oh, okay. Thanks, Keys. No, I wanted that. Hit me. I want him to actually hit me. Because he does half a heart of damage. Alright, well, it was not a very good Puppet Ganon. It's still better than my PB by a wide shot. Alright, 127.17 Puppet Ganon. New Puppet Ganon PB at least. Alright, well now I guess we just have to pray. A and B for that. This place gives you nightmares. I don't blame you. I'm sure I'll have nightmares about this place also. I like how tense it is with there being no music whatsoever. Alright, who's ready for failure? I know I am. Take some more damage. Obviously, I'm not at a quarter heart like I need to be. Let's not fall off the edge, though. Oop-doo. Any of the arrows. Will we get it? Probably not, but we can always dream. If I'd actually like hovered forward and over there, that would have worked, but oh well. Oh, I forgot to, dang it. I wanted to save and then turn on hero mode. Try number two. Hope you're all ready to sit here for probably more than an hour doing this. Nice. Nice heart. Now we have like 20 minutes to get the hover. Tried to see if I could get that one that I knew was going to come up under. All right, this time we're going to save. Alright, so now it's not gonna take as long to damage down. Thank you for the good luck, Kyle Precise. We're certainly gonna need it. But I don't have to get that bomb drop. Bow before I drew my sword. Well, that probably skipped what would have been a failed attempt. Alright, back to the actual attempts. Oh, I should have gone forward. Oh, my god. Assuming, like, first try-ish, like, just 8 minutes. Normally, after Ganon, or after Puppet Ganon, takes, like, a little over 6 minutes to beat Ganon. It's like, just put in 8 minutes, why not? What is this, attempt number, like, 4 or something? Shots probably. Oh no. Okay. Let's go, fairies, you and me. I think we were, like, correctly aligned, but I don't know if that would have made it or not. I'm pretty sure the fairy was too far off to the left or right on that one. Like, if I was in line with it based on where the camera was, it would have, like, been in front or behind Link. Like, depth perception tricks you a lot in this game, especially when going for the fairy hover. I turn the camera the way I do so that if it is, like, really far forward, I can maybe switch to double mashing to maybe get it. So now they're just, like, to the left or right. like those attempts were not close. One was really far to Link's left, and one was really far to Link's right. But the depth perception, the depth perception can make it look otherwise. Thank you. arrow. Or a good bow. Went all the way over to the left. I was confused. Yeah, just hover into the loading zone, why not? I have a few more tries. Fairies crisscross below each other, randomly moving around. We need to talk about my gambling addiction. Gambling with the speedrun gods. Speedrun Illuminati are real. You guys notice how the third fairy is always missing? Okay, attempt number, whatever this is. Maybe it's that one? I think they're too far to links right. We died anyway. It's impossible to find a consistent setup for this. The fairy movement is random. Unless you figure out how to somehow manipulate fairy RNG. Which I don't think is going to happen either. Oh, maybe if he turns? Yeah, where's the great fairy mask? We need to attract these fairies towards us. two-handed mashing suck right now. Dog wasn't gonna make it anyway. I didn't go offline. I've dropped like 300 frames the entire stream. He's gotten first try before. Or wait, I think Linkus might have, but then he screwed up the Ganon fight. No one's gotten first try and completed a run. That was the slowest item slight increase I've ever seen. How do I do what like what? Turn around. I don't know how I missed that part of the sentence. I assume you're talking about during the item slide. You just hold forward before taking out the bomb. I dropped the inputs at the exact wrong time. Oh. slide. This input display is made by Dragonbane. I think the only link to it might be in the Discord server we have for Wind Waker HD speedrunning. But if you want to go to that Discord server, it's on the, a link to it's on the Wind Waker HD speedrun.com resources page. Yeah, the movement RNG of fairies is frame-based. This is dumb. I'm glad you noticed. Alright, well, we got a PB, so that's cool. Assuming I don't die. This is not going to be record. This is going to be like 11 minutes behind record. But yes, we're going to save like 25 minutes, so that's cool. Probably one of the biggest time saves I've ever had on any split. Actually, no, that's false. My second Ocarina of Time 90% speedrun, I saved like an hour and a half on wrong warping. Yeah. thank you for the 5 bits, the real blue. Yeah, Math Girl, Endless Night, like, affects the lighting during... It affects the lighting during this cutscene. During the Ganon fight, I think the lighting's the same. But it also, for some reason, the Endless Night lighting actually affects the credits. So, like, when you're sailing away with Tetra, it's actually, like, really stormy and dark. Which is kind of funny. Also, Beetle's in the wrong location. For the 50 bits dead nuggets. Oh my god, too soon, Captain Horde. That joke, though. Yeah, the lighting is, again, messed up during this fight because the game is trying to apply the Endless Night weather effects to it. Records 156. Nice time save. So yeah, wall number two. You will give cake for one more run. Sorry, but I've had too much sugar today. I have to go eat an actual dinner. so that's my second completed run of Wind Waker HD any percent. So that's cool. Not sub Paido. What's Paidoix's MST PB? Oh man, Fino with the after PB host. Thank you very much, Fino.